Hello everyone, you're welcome back. In today's class, I want to take you guys out to cut a shift dress. You can also call it a free dress or maybe like a shape, just shift dress. But it's gonna be a short dress. You understand? A short free dress. So to determine the fabric you are going to fold, I think the hip is the biggest part of the measurement. So use your hip measurement plus the allowance you are going to add and all that to determine what you fold on the fabric. So I think this will be enough for me to cut the dress. So now I want to cut the front part. So now you are going to measure 13 to 14 inches downward. So that is where you are going to fold from. I want you to have side dart. So just measure 14 inches or 13 inches downward from this side and you fold. Mind you are slanting towards your bust point. You understand? So what you are going to fold in, you can actually fold either 1.5 inch, depending on how busted the person is. So you can fold 1 inch in or 1.5 inch. Measure 12 inches downward, 13 or 14, then you fold it, slant it towards your bust point. So this is the down, this is the full measurement. This place I'm folding now is going to be the folded part and the down part. So since it's a free dress, if you want to put lining, fine. If you don't want to put lining, you can actually just, can you call it, sew it like that. So this is my bust point. This is my under bust. I'm not really making use of waistline, so this is my hip line. I believe we all know how to get hip line. From shoulder to hip line, I think it's around 25 or 24 inches. So now what you are going to do after getting these lines, you are going to divide your actual body measurement. You are going to add extra 3 inches to your actual body measurement. Then you divide by 4 plus 2 inches allowance. So waist measurement now, plus 3 inches divided by 4, then plus the 2 inches allowance. The same thing on the hip line, because it's going to be a free dress, not going to carry zip. So that 3 inches extra you're adding to it will enable you wear it freely. So get your shoulder measurement divided by 2 plus the little half inch for the joining, 7 inches for the armhole. 7 inches for the armhole curve. Then this one you connect together and just make out that little A shape. Don't get it wrong. 3 inches or 2 inches to your normal actual body measurement divided by 4 plus 2 inches sewing allowance. So after cutting out, this is the way it's going to look like. So now the neckline, just determine which kind of neckline you want. Here I'm making use of 4-4. 4 deep, 4 wide. You can put whichever neck you want to put. So now place the front bodies on the remaining fabric to cut out the back. The back too doesn't really have a standard measurement. Just depend on the kind of neckline you want. So depend on how deep you want it to, depend on how wide and how high you want it. So it doesn't have a standard measurement. So yeah, you can decide to just come down by 1 inch. That's for the back. Then if you like, you make it deep. So I'm still leaving that 1.5 inches at the upper part. For the back is higher than the front. So cut out the same shape, follow the same shape. Now you take it down straight. And your shift dress is ready. that the body is ready. Just like I said, if you like, you put lining. If you don't want to put lining, maybe you just want to make it like that. So all you need is, so this back now, in case the neck is small, you can just open it. You open it and pipe it so that it will be able to enter your head freely. But if the neck is wide enough, then there is no need of opening the back neck part. That's what I'm talking about. So now to join it, it's very easy. That side that we folded the other time, all you need to do is just pick that side that, then you sew it 5 inches or 5.5 inches in. Do the same thing on the both side. So after when you might have done that, you iron it, then you place it on the back body. Just take your body measurement and join it. Join the shoulder, then you pipe the neckline. That's if you're not using lining. But if you're using lining, you use lining to turn everything in. So now to get the sleeve, it's a little bit puff. Just get your 5 inches here for the armhole cuff. And if you feel this fabric is not wide enough, you can add to it. So now take your armhole circumference measurement like this, plus the little allowance you use in joining it. So you are going to use elastic on this sleeve. So this down part, you can equally fold it in flare form. Then you can also extend it if you still want it bigger, if you want it to pour very well. But this is the one I want to use. Doesn't have a standard measurement. So from here, you measure 5 or 6 inches in. That is where you are going to insert the elastic. You are going to place the elastic on that part, then you sew it on it. You place the elastic on that part, then you sew it up to the other edge. Mind you, your fabric can be wider than this, or you even cut it halfly, fold it in bias form. Can you call it, do it like that too? Then you can leave it straight. I'm leaving this one straight because of the pattern of the fabric, and I don't want it to be too much big. But if you want your own to be bigger, then you extend the fabric. So place on it like this. Then you start drawing the elastic. When you draw the elastic and sew on it, it's going to gather the cloth together. We're going to gather the cloth together like this. Remember, the more fabric you use, the more you experience puff, yeah? The more you're going to have puff there. So, if you want your own to be bigger, use a bigger fabric. A bigger material for the sleeve so that it will puff more. So you're going to sew it all through. So after when you might have done this now, I think the sleeve is ready. So just turn it the other way around. So this is it. The sleeve is ready. So all you need to do is to just attach it to the dress. No, I know it's easy, it's something you guys can do, but I just want to do this sleeve so that you guys will see it, the outcome and the way it will look like. So imagine the fabric is bigger than this now. Definitely, the puff will come out more, unlike the way it is. But I wanted just little, so that is why I use the little fabric that I use. So that's that about the sleeve. So after attaching it in, our shift dress is ready. It's as simple as that. If you follow it diligently, it's not going to give you hard time. Thank you very much, everybody, for watching. Please don't forget to share and subscribe.